Hey y'all, Irix Guy here, back again. Now, if you haven't heard already, Apple unveiled the iPad Air 2. Now, like most Apple products, and that's what's so awesome about Apple. They're a design company, they're a user interface company, and most everything they put out, the newer edition, most everything is better than the previous edition. So you've got the Apple iPad Air 2. Now it is thinner, and you've seen that commercial where they had the pencil. This even has part of that pencil shaved off, and that's their way of acknowledging, hey, this is a thinner device. Well, why would one want to purchase the Apple iPad Air 2, or why would they want to upgrade? Now, these are my personal opinions, and I love Apple. Don't get me wrong. I'm a huge Apple fanboy, and it's not just because it's like, ooh, it's Apple, that's cool. It's because I utilize their products for productivity. IrixGuy's Adventure Channel, youtube.com/IrixGuy. I do all of my video editing, all of my photography, all of that on a Mac. And I'm ever since Mac went OS 10, Unix-based operating system, ever since Mac went OS 10, I abandoned Linux. I loved Linux. I was one of the first users of Slackware. And I used several flavors of commercial Unix as well. But when Mac OS 10 came out, it was good looking. I had my commercial apps that I could use to edit photos at the time, and now it's become more of a video editing platform for me. But yeah, so the Apple iPad Air 2, you get the little Touch ID for your fingerprint, which is nice. That's a good convenience. Is that a reason to upgrade? For many people, it may be. If you've got an older iPad, maybe iPad 1 or iPad 2, maybe it's time to upgrade. But in my scenario, I got the phablet, which is a mix between a phone and a tablet, the iPhone 6 Plus. So it's big enough to where I can comfortably use it. And to step up to a larger size display, such as an iPad Air 2, for me personally, it's not something that I need. Because and everybody's different. Everybody's in a different situation. But sometimes one encounters technological overload. In my scenario, I've got the iMac, I've got the MacBook Air. So if I'm editing videos in the studio, I've got an iMac. If I'm on the internet while I'm in bed or whatever, I've got a MacBook Air. And if I'm out riding my bicycle or cruising out in my boat, I've got the iPhone 6 Plus. So where does iPad Air 2 fit into my scenario? For me, it doesn't. For me, it would just be an expense to where I have something else sitting around taking up physical desktop storage space on a tabletop beside the bed or in my office or wherever, wherever that thing may be sitting. It's just taking up space. So for me, I'm not going to get the iPad Air 2. But with that said, I'm not bashing the iPad Air 2. I think the iPad Air 2, as far as technology is concerned, is obviously the latest and greatest. It's got the fastest processor of the iPads. It's got the Touch ID for the fingerprint. And it's something that someone that didn't have a laptop and a desktop or an iPhone, it would probably be a good fit. Or if someone had a smaller iPhone to where the display is kind of cumbersome, they may want a bigger pleasure device, for reading websites and reading e-books or whatever. I'm not a big reader. I'd rather watch a movie or I'd rather create a movie than to sit down and read. Nothing wrong with reading. I mean, it's a good thing for people to do. I mean, it's healthy for the brain, and it encourages one to better improve their grammatical skills. How's that? But anyway, those are my thoughts regarding the iPad Air 2. Be sure to subscribe if you haven't already, youtube.com/IrixGuy, and enjoy all my videos. Even though I did not jump on the iPad Air 2, I did jump on the iMac with Retina 5K display. So stay tuned for unboxing, stay tuned for review, and stay tuned for an abundance of videos that I film in 4K with the GoPro Hero 4 Black Edition. Thanks for watching, and y'all have a good day.